For some, it's a drive down memory lane as a familiar brand is making its way back into the St. Louis market. It's a ubiquitous, oversized part of St. Louis. Only the Arch along the riverfront, or Catsup Bottle in Collinsville, or Budweiser Eagle can lay claim to being a bigger iconic landmark around the region than the big Amoco sign.
It's strange. I mean, you get used to people talking about it, but it's very cool. You know, people from all over the United States see and recognize it, know where it is. Oh yeah, I know where that is. From the base, the belly, 40 foot tall and 60 foot wide.
And at Clayton and Skinker in the city of St. Louis, the world's largest Amoco sign is being rebranded. BP, which bought Amoco in 1998, has been slowly rebranding gas stations nationwide. And team members at this shop are used to sightseers stopping in.
It's historic. It's been here for so many years, and people, look for it and they know it.
On Wednesday morning, the Stevenson's High Point Amoco will hold an official ribbon-cutting ceremony with the mayor and city officials to mark this roadside attraction. While it might feel like going back to the future for some, the oversized iconic landmark has been a part of this community for decades, since 1932. The service station, ran by Daryl Rodenberg's stepfather, LeClaire Stevenson, was a standard Red Crown in 1951 before becoming the big Amoco sign in the 1970s.
He came in to operate this site after coming home from World War II. And came here, started working for Standard Oil. It's awesome for us to see, a business that's a family-owned business that's been here for so long, 72 plus years.
Well, you can walk down memory lane and drive to Gasoline Alley. They will have a formal ribbon cutting with the mayor and other dignitaries at 10 a.m. Wednesday morning. Near Forest Park, Patrick Clark, Fox 2 News.